Hi, everyone. My son, Henry, and my daughter, Amelia, are downstairs listening to Mrs. Fortune during her story hour. So I thought that this would be a good time for me to read one more story to you for today, because I know that the weekend is coming up in just a couple of days, and that's always a time where you kind of need some extra books, or your parents might need a little bit of extra time to catch up on things, so we can share a story together. This one is going to be Strictly No Elephants. I bought this book at the Scholastic Book Fair at school a few years ago, so if you were shopping at the same book fair I was shopping at, you might have this one too. Let's see. So, Strictly No Elephants. The trouble with having a tiny elephant for a pet is that you never quite fit in. No one else has an elephant. So we have some people here with dogs for pets, cats, birds, goldfish. Wonder if any of you have pets at home. Every day, I take my elephant for a walk. His is a very thoughtful kind of walk. Do you see the elephant holding the umbrella for his friend? Oops. He doesn't like the cracks in the sidewalk so much. I always go back and help him over. That's what friends do. Lift each other over the cracks. I'm having trouble with the pages. Today, I'm walking my tiny elephant to number 17. It's pet club day, and everyone will be there. Look at everyone going down the street with all their pets to pet club day. Come along. There's a good boy. I coax him over the last few feet. It'll be fine. He has to carry his elephant over the stepping stones. When I look up, there's a sign on the door. Oh, it says, Strictly No Elephants. Well, that is a grumpy looking host. My tiny elephant leads me back to the sidewalk, never minding the cracks. That's what friends do. They brave the scary things for you. My own pet has just walked into the room. You might hear Zoe's collar jingle. So here we have the elephant and the little boy walking back home now. And they see another little girl right here. I wonder what she's doing. Did you try to go to the pet club meeting too? The girl asks. Yes, I say. But they don't allow elephants. The sign didn't mention skunks, the girl says. But they don't want us to play with them either. Oh, they don't know any better, I said. Okay. He doesn't stink, the girl adds. No, he doesn't, I agree. So what if we start our own club? Sounds nice. Here go the tiny elephant and the skunk. Come along, I say, making certain that my tiny elephant follows me, because that's what friends do. You never leave anyone behind. Look at all the new pets that we found. We got someone with a giraffe, and I think an armadillo, a baby narwhal. You don't see that often. Hedgehog. Maybe porcupine, depending on the scale, a penguin, and an elephant and the skunk. We even have someone who has a bat for a pet. These are different kind of pets, aren't they? We can play here, one of our new friends says. All of us. So, we paint our own sign, and their sign now says, all are welcome. My tiny elephant will give you directions if you need them. Because that's what friends do. I know we're all kind of missing our friends this week. I've really liked seeing the pictures of you all watching these stories and watching your teachers read stories. And it's been really fun to see your parents upload those in the Facebook group so that your teachers can see them too. I look forward to reading another one with you soon, and I hope you all have a good rainy and soggy day. Bye.